16, second hearing consideration of adopting an ordinance levying property taxes for the city of San Angelo for the 2014 tax year and ordinance fixing and levying ad valorem taxes for the current tax year for use in supporting the municipal government of the city of San Angelo, Texas for the 2014-2015 budget year, providing for the assessment and collection thereof, providing when the tax shall become due, providing when the tax shall become delinquent, providing for exemptions, providing for severability, providing for publication on the city-operated website, providing for an effective date. Ms. Farmer.
I didn't pull this. We had a citizen did. I authorized that the citizen's request be honored. I will take the opportunity to point out again for those who are not aware that your property tax consists of three different venues, the school district, the county, and the city. And the city only controls their portion of the tax rate, and this council has either lowered or maintained. The last 10 years we have reduced a total of 10 cents on valuation of 100. The city has not increased property taxes, and we do not intend to increase them this go around, and this is the second reading of that, and that answers the lady in the audience that requested it. That's what it is, or if she'd like to speak, I'm more than happy to hear from her.
Do I have public comment on this? I'll ask you to identify yourself, and I've given you 3 minutes, ma'am.
Okay. My name is Deborah Bailey, and realize that the tax rate is going to stay the same. It's not changing. However, our property values have increased, so all of our taxes have increased. And again, I realize that the city controls only the part that the city controls, that the school board and the county control the other two parts. The city did put out a film saying why we have such high property taxes, which we do have. The city has one of the highest in the state as far as just the city taxes. Throughout their film, they have tried to justify the higher rate in San Angelo, and they've used the word comparable repeatedly. I'm not sure why anyone thinks that the city of San Angelo should have comparable revenue to the cities of Midland and Odessa, Wichita Falls, and Abilene. Decided that the average value of a home in San Angelo is lower than in these other cities. Therefore, we should pay more taxes so the city has comparable revenue. Perhaps the average home value is lower because the average wage in San Angelo is lower. I didn't see any comparison of wages in the film. Discussed in the film, San Angelo lacks a commercial and industrial tax base. I don't think that homeowners should be expected to make up for that tax base. Isn't the lack of commerce and industry by design? San Angelo's never been known as welcoming for industry. Look at the reaction when the oil boom came to town. But the homeowners need to make up for the loss of an income that we never had. San Angelo has the smallest population of these cities. That alone should say that San Angelo would collect less taxes since the tax base is smaller. It also explains why the city collects less in sales tax. The city will see an increase of $4.4 million in tax revenue due to an increase in home values and an increase in sales tax during this next year. And it appears that they plan to spend every dime of it. I agree we need to increase the wages of our police officers. I don't think that justifies an across-the-board 5% raise for all city employees. And what happens when the value of our homes drops? The city's already budgeted to spend all of the money. I think a better plan would be to increase the budget by 3-4% and give homeowners a break. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
If I could, what you say, you know, is accurate to a point. If I may, for the council, the comparison when we compare to other cities, and we as a council have been trying to bring city employees and salaries up to at least 85-90% of the national averages. In order to do that, they're paid out of property taxes in order to bring those wages up. That's the difference in your theory. In order for us to increase, in order for us to take care of the infrastructure and to fix streets and to do the things, that's what it's paid from, is those property taxes. And we have been conscious of the property values going up, and we have not raised that rate because we are getting more monies to help pay for infrastructure items and other items in the city and to bring those salaries up to a living wage. If anyone else up here would like to chime in on the explanation of that, I would love to hear it.
I would just also like to say, San Angelo does give an exemption as a homestead exemption, and these other cities do not. Some give none, and they give lesser amounts. So homeowners still get an exemption, which tries to balance this out. I understand exactly what you're saying, and we've had the same discussions. Good points, ma'am.
Mayor.
Ruby?
I think one of the reasons why we're compared to these other cities is because of the size of San Angelo. There aren't just a lot of cities, unless they're mega cities or they're very small towns, that are that size. So that's how we got grouped in with that group. When you're looking at that group, and I've been told this pretty much my whole life, San Angelo is one of the largest cities in the United States that's not on an interstate. Well, the interstate is what makes the difference on the commerce for a big portion of that. And that's why we don't have as much commercial businesses taking place here as in those sister cities over there. The one thing that I'll say, and I think that we're getting better as this as a city council, is that past city councils and past staff we've kicked this can so far down the road on improvements to our infrastructure that someone has to eventually suck it up and do it. And we're going to have to be those people. I don't want my kids, I don't want San Angelo to be in bankruptcy when our system is falling down around us, and I'm not going to cut taxes in order to save just a little bit of money. When you're talking $4.5 million, right now, just in roads alone, we have $150 million that we could put out there right now to try to improve the roads inside of our city. We're so far behind that 1 point, or that 4.5 is not, it's a drop in the bucket. So we can't do that. I don't think we can do that. We can't cut, and in fact, I wouldn't be opposed to raising it somewhat, but I think it's good that we have it here right now, and I think we've started on the right path of going down and accepting responsibility for our past. In the past, so many people that have been up here in these positions have sat there and tried to appease their constituents out there and try to say, okay, well, I'm going to do what you want. I'll lower the taxes, or I'll do this. You know, I want to do what you guys want to do, but I'm not going to do it that's going to hurt the whole city as a whole.
Don?
One of the things also on property evaluation is that's driven by the state for the school districts. There has to be close to a 95% valuation for those things to get the maximum amount of monies from the school district. Along with that, a lot of people are hurting from the fact that the school district, year before last, dropped their homestead exemption, and now that's coming up on our bills for our taxes. You know, even though the school district has a surplus this year, they're still not evaluating, looking at their exemption for the residences. So all those things together is what's causing the problem.
And one further point, some cities pay a hospital tax. San Angelo does not do that. And if I am not mistaken, and I'll apologize if I am, but I think Abilene also pays a hospital tax on top of their city taxes. And if I'm also not mistaken, I think that Odessa and Midland pay a college tax, which is on top of there. So, you know, just because our city tax rates are lower or higher does not mean that that's all the taxes people pay. There's other variables as well. And according to the film, when everything is said and done, San Angelo is actually not the highest as far as the amounts we pay. Further comments on this before we go on? Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
I just wanted to add, one thing is Mr. Fleming stated it, but maybe it wasn't caught. We are, this year, this council, is saddled with the debt that was incurred 10 years ago, 15 years ago, and that has to go into what you say we have received in increases. We're paying off debt from the previous years, and most citizens forget that. It's a long-term situation. You don't pay your house off in most people don't, in 10, 15 years, and we're still paying debt from operations of several years ago.
Yes, sir. Do you have comments, sir?
Mr. Mayor, honorable council members, first of all, I would like to
would
say
you, would you please identify yourself?
My name is Wayne Hill, sorry.
Thank you.
First of all, I'd like to say that I viewed this video, the budget 101 property taxes, which was prepared in an attempt to justify San Angelo's higher tax rates. I personally found the video to be insulting and irrelevant, and I deeply resent the fact the city would spend our hard-earned tax dollars on such a video. Trying to rationalize tax rates between cities that are dissimilar is an exercise in futility. The focus should be on the spending side of the budget rather than the revenue side. Any comparable analysis between cities should compare spending for recurring items based on comparable metrics. For example, you know, why pay comparison for city employees for light jobs or maintenance costs per mile of comparable streets? Meaningful comparisons can be made on the spending side, the revenue side. It's a dependent variable, not vice versa. The oil boom has created a windfall of a 9.75% increase in property tax revenues and 12% increase in sales tax revenues. It appears the city has considered the tax windfall as an opportunity to increase spending to the detriment of San Angelo property owners. The budget should be established on the spending need, not on revenues available. I would have expected an increase in the budget of 4 to 5% at most, with a portion of the windfall returned to the residents in the form of lower tax rates to offset some of the increase in taxes. The San Angelo City residents should not have to pay more in property taxes because of the oil boom, but only to fund the necessary expenditures. I am not speaking so much for me, as I'm over 65 and most of my taxes are grandfathered, but my heart goes out to those not similarly situated. I received an email from Susan Martinez, who lives in a modest neighborhood just off Bell Street near this convention center. She asked me to please speak for her at this meeting. She paid $55,000 for her home that now has a tax appraisal of over $100,000, despite the fact the neighborhood has deteriorated since the purchase. Lower priced homes have appreciated more on a percentage basis than higher priced homes. This is putting a burden on our lower income residents struggling to make ends meet. Their lives should not become more difficult in order to pay increased taxes due to the oil boom. The recent 20% increase in school taxes due to the elimination of the homestead exemption compounds this pain. The budget as proposed will set a new base for spending. What happens next year? Higher tax rates to cover the budget increases? What happens when the oil boom tapers off? The proposed budget appears to be a classic ratchet up spending during tax windfalls and raise rates when the windfalls level out or decline. So please reconsider spending the entire windfall. Lower the tax rate so that the increase of the actual tax paid provides the revenues for a reasonable increase in spending. Spending increases should not generally exceed the combined rate of inflation plus the increase in population. The increased spending in the proposed budget appears to be excessive and unconscionable. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Do I have further comments? Then I will open it up for a motion to approve or deny.
Move to approve.
Have a motion to approve the budget. Do I have a second?
Second.
Do that. John, would you second?
The tax levy.
Tax levy. Okay, we do have a motion to approve the tax levy, and the second. We have had comment. Is there any other comment? I do appreciate your comments. I appreciate you being here, and I appreciate the citizen involvement, because this is all our city. So thank you for your comments. Do I have further comment from council? Then I will call for the vote. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Put 6-0 on that one.